The world's economic system and our daily lives are largely dependent on data centers. According to a study by the EU Digital Strategy, data centers in the EU alone are expected to consume 3.2% of electricity by 2030. Making the expanding data centers more energy efficient and environmentally friendly has become a priority for the European Union.
The way the technology works is very inefficient in the sense that it converts electrical power into heat at about 0.03% of the energy that goes into the IT comes out as a string of ones and zeros. Yeah, if we put in 100 megawatts of power into a large data center, 99 megawatts of that is thermal power.
John Summers is the scientific lead at the RISE ICE Data Center Lab in Luleå, Sweden, and part of the European We District project. The aim of the project on site? Demonstrate in real life whether it's feasible to reuse waste heat from a local data center for present district heating. Research Programme Manager at RISE, Jonas Gustafsson, knows more about the demonstration site.
The main objective of this demo site is to demonstrate the use of data centers in combination with fuel cells to achieve heat recovery from data center and fuel cells directly into district heating systems without the use of heat pumps.
The problem is that the waste heat from standard data centers only reaches around 35 degrees Celsius, not hot enough to be used in today's district heating systems. By introducing fuel cell technology, the temperature of today's district heating systems could be reached.
Data centers generate a lot of heat. We use the fuel cell as a way of upgrading the heat that we get from the data center, but it also provides power to the data centers.
Especially in countries like Sweden, where temperatures can drop below minus 30 degrees Celsius, this waste heat recovery system is promising. The demonstrator in Luleå eventually used the waste heat to heat adjacent facilities during the winter.
The heat recovery system works like this, that the heat being produced in the data center is being delivered from the data center container into the fuel cell container, where it's preheating the incoming air. So the heat being produced from the fuel cells can be maximized.
Instead of using fans, modern computer cooling technology was used to make waste heat from the data center more accessible.
The demonstrator here is combining the fuel cells with a data center that is using another technology, liquid cooling, where you actually immerse the microelectronics into a dielectric liquid. And so you're capturing all the heat from the electronics using that approach.
A heat exchanger connects the liquid to a water circuit that preheats the air temperature in the fuel cell compartment. This cooling technique has an additional advantage.
It's much quieter than a traditional data center in that sense. So it would be absolutely perfect for urban uses.
Initially, the researchers wanted to use hydrogen fuel cells to minimize the CO2 emissions. However, due to a lack of green hydrogen, they switched to biogas with solid oxide fuel cells.
The biogas is stored in an on-site container, keeping the gas of up to 200 bars of pressure. Then the pressure is reduced down to 30 millibars. The gas is then, through pipes, led to the fuel cell, where the gas is converted into electricity and heat, so it's a very integrated system.
The demonstrator setup holds many advantages.
There's a sort of a symbiosis between the data center and the fuel cells. So the idea would be that it could become grid independent. It could run in island mode, and it's just converting biogas into digital services. The next generation, if you like, of the concept would be to include batteries within the loop as well.
I would see a good potential for this, especially if you have piped gas available, so you don't need to store the biogas locally.
But is it really feasible to use waste heat from data centers for today's district heating systems? One major drawback is that their heat demand is seasonal, but waste heat is produced continuously.
One of the problems we have is that the consumption of thermal energy varies dramatically between winter and summer. You know, the data center It doesn't know, it doesn't care whether it's winter or summer. It would be good to, if we could have, if the network could also have storage, thermal storage, so that you store it and then you use it later. Well, that's a big challenge.
Right now, many new laws and regulations are addressing energy efficiency and targeting the use of waste heat from data centers. But scientists say there's still a long way to go and more research is needed.